Nightline continues from New York City with Terry Moran.
It's wet, it's muddy, and it's full of pain. It's a Tough Mudder, a wildly popular worldwide competition designed by the British Special Forces. It claims it's, quote, probably the toughest event on the planet. How tough? Well, think electrocution, dunks in freezing water, and running miles in slippery mud. We sent ABC's Matt Gutman to find out if he has what it takes to make it through this agonizing race.
A what? A mudder. Definition. A person who pays to crawl through, be encrusted in, and sometimes flip into mud. A tough one is a person who does it over 12 and a half miles through electrified wire and what seem to be medieval torture devices. Perhaps the toughest mudder?
You got blown up, it was an IED, and when you woke up, you were actually surprised that your leg was still there?
Yeah.
And then you asked for it to be amputated. Why would you do that?
Why would I have a bum leg and I'll just be walking through the cane? Well, that's pretty much worthless.
Former Marine Ben Lunak lost his leg in Iraq in 2005. He hasn't looked back, climbing Kilimanjaro last year and now attempting this, along with 6,000 other runners near Phoenix, Arizona. It's just one of 35 Tough Mudder events this year, one of the fastest growing businesses in America, going from 50,000 participants in 2010 to a projected 500,000 in 2012. And so every Tough Mudder begins with a preemptive pledge to suck it up.
I love it!
Why would anybody do this to themselves?
You know, people want to prove something to themselves. It's for everyone, it's a different reason. Some it's that they're bored with conventional fitness. Some it's that they're sitting at their office job and nothing's actually scared them since they were about 9 years old.
Alex Patterson is Tough Mudder's marketing chief. He's the guy who comes up with names like Arctic Enema and Funky Monkey. A Harvard grad with a law degree, his job is partly to conjure up these sadistic obstacles and partly to ensure the company doesn't get sued for them.
What's in store next? Oh, what's in store next? It's the Arctic Enema. It's a dumpster full of ice water that's just absolutely freezing. It's the mother of all ice cream headaches.
It was pretty cold. I don't want to tell you about my nether regions, but they no longer exist.
Take me with you! Take me with you!
I was joking, kind of. At $150 a ticket, raking in tens of millions of dollars a year, the company may be the pacemaker, but the entire challenge race industry is grabbing America by the jockstrap. One of the reasons for its success is camaraderie. Quickly, Ben was becoming an inspiration to the other runners. Twinkle Toes was the only obstacle he thought he'd fail. But the miles and the pain begin to pile up.
This can't just be halfway, less than halfway.
Well, I mean, it's 12 and a half miles, so that's the 6 mile mark, yep.
Ben's prosthesis begins to fill with mud. The cold starts to dig into us. If you're a mudder, you now start to have fun.
Let me wash my face.
The array of obstacles verges on the absurd, a smorgasbord of pain. This is called walk the plank. The water, frigid and deep, divers are there to ensure nobody drowns. Serious business, where no one seems to take themselves too seriously. By now, Ben's prosthesis is so clogged with mud, he can barely walk. We'd been sure he'd make it through. Now, not so much. By the time we reach this doomsday machine, my teeth are chattering uncontrollably. Life was about to get much worse.
So now we have 10,000 volts of electricity, live dangling wires. People say, is that legal in America? Well, at least right now it is.
First, Ben goes through, flag in hand. Not only do we get shocked, but Ben and I are knocked out cold, falling face first in the mud. We try to get up, bang, zinged again, lights out.
That was insane. I blacked out several times. You were talking to me
someone was talking to me and I was flat out in the mud. I woke up in the mud. That was so cool!
Traditional Tough Mudder beer in hand, we toasted ourselves and the toughest mudder. Another bunch of muddy, freezing, but satisfied customers.
You should be taken out of Miami.
For Nightline, I'm Matt Gutman in Phoenix, Arizona.
Way to go, Matt. Thanks for doing that for us.